Hello dear listeners, welcome to They Said It. This is your host Gayatri Govindraju and I am back with another interesting topic today. What if there are yardsticks to measure your self-worth? But how do we define such yardsticks? We would sometimes in our life enter a situation where we need to show and prove our value. It could be a business proposal, a job interview, or personally between friends or among family members. Whatever may be the scene, we may have to participate in discussions, make negotiations, and be able to continue and hold the communication until we have a concrete agreement or decision. In this case, it is important to make our points clear and show our worth. Show the worth. Here comes our topic of the day. What is the value that we have? How can we get paid for what we are worth for? Well, no one pays us for our worth. Rather, they pay us for what they think we are worth. Wait. And how do you control their thinking? Is that even possible to make a person think the way you wanted? Well, yes, it is possible. It is possible to make a person realize your worth when we ourselves have a clarity about our worth and be able to clearly communicate it. Every one of us wants to be paid well for what we do. And we all love to get recognized for our brilliant work in the form of rewards or incentives or a firm appreciation. This is an undeniable fact. This is pertinent to anybody, a business owner, an employee, or even a job seeker. How nice. But why do people tend to underprice their actual value? A recent corporate survey says that it is women who underprice themselves more than men. Maybe the gender-based wage gap makes it more evident? Feel free to write me a comment about this statement. Coming back to the topic, even in informal conversations, I realize some of us, including myself, are not comfortable in expressing or communicating their value. They say that it feels like tooting my own horn. I don't like to boast myself or my own qualities. With permission today, I would like to share a story of my friend who realized her value and learned to efficiently communicate it. She owns and successfully runs a boutique. She even has employed several people to help her in day-to-day business. Despite all this, when she has to introduce herself to any of her clients, she would say, "I have a small boutique in a mall downtown." That way, unknowingly, she was putting her own business low in the eyes of prospects and clients. And she was in a way diminishing herself into the loop of low confidence conversations. All this has impacted her actual ability. Her misfaith in her capability and self-worth made her feel small and insufficient to serve bigger clients. This in turn stopped her to approach bigger clients or to expand with new ideas and create more value to her existing clients. One day, she realized that this whole process is impacting her in various dimensions, personally, professionally, and financially. She felt that the language that she has been using to present herself and her work does not communicate all that she had to offer. In simple words, she found out that she is just giving away her services with no assessment about the actual value that she is offering. She immediately took responsibility to re-evaluate her pricing. She asked herself various questions about the client's needs, her unique selling points, unique qualities that can better the services, the value that she can bring to her clients, and more and more. She redefined her value to her clients that they get from working with her, calculated the ROI, the return on investment, and it was a shock. She found out that she has to nearly double her prices, which terrified her initially, but her instinct said that the value is there. She was still worried. What if no one wouldn't see it positively? What if the overall business fails because of the new model? Well, she finally decided to communicate the new improvements to all her clients along with the upgraded prices. She prepared herself with all the bottleneck questions that she might have to face from her clients. You know what happened? To her pleasant surprise, most of her clients did not have a problem with her new proposal. She found her authentic true voice to communicate her own worth. When we are confident that our work would add value, it does not feel like bragging or tooting our own horn. When we love what we do and when the work that we do excites us, communicating our value comes naturally in one's own style. She says that since she started realizing her value, she stopped calling her boutique a small boutique, rather started introducing her business with the name. She also shared with me about the differences that she observed with her meetings. Earlier, the meetings used to be a little hard with tough clients, and now her preparedness and the way she shares the details has become smooth and progressively improving. She started showing progress tangibly with the help of samples, labels, etc., rather than just listening to the client's requirements and parroting the acceptance. The way of doing her job has become easier, fun-filled, and less panicky. This story does not have an end. Realizing our self-worth has to be a continuous process. We need this in every walk of our life. Being properly valued is very important. Confidence is the key to knowing our self-worth. To take any new step in the career or business or make a decision in personal life, it is natural and normal to feel fear and doubtful. But we should remember that this should not limit our potential to achieve bigger goals or the potential to earn for our value. When I mention self-worth and value, it is not just limited to finances. It is way beyond and above. It is all about our personal sphere of self-respect and self-confidence. When we start thinking about what more we can do and what more we can give, this will be the first step to break the barriers to achieve bigger goals. Let me conclude today's episode with a quotation that I recently read. If you are a giver, remember to learn your limits, because the takers do not have any. As long as you give, there are always people to take without even realizing the importance. So, it is on our shoulders to know our worth and show it to others. That is all for today. I hope you liked today's episode. If you liked it, share it across your friends and family. Follow the show to get notified about the new releases. Don't forget to follow us on social media. Until I catch up with you in another interesting episode, keep making connections with your roots. This is your host, Gayatri Govindraju, signing off. Bye-bye.